get ready to match the stars. Michael Evans, Brett Summers, Gary Burghoff, Joyce Bulifant, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there.
Hey, yes.
Send this very awesome thank you to your friends and gentle hearts. What?
You can't be a celebrity with her fans.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, that's really nice.
I wanted to wear that bow tie you bought for me in Paris, and it broke just as we were putting it on, the thread. What do you buy these cheap ties for?
yeah, you look terrific, but let me tell you.
What? he's gone bananas, hasn't he?
That's what my uncle was buried in one, just like...
Oh.
Can I come back?
Yeah, you can come back.
I'm just kidding.
Listen now. Are you still on All in the Family?
Yeah, but starting Monday, we're going to be making a new show. They're going to be making a new show, and I'm just going to be in it, and it's about the Jefferson family, and it's going to be on right after All in the Family. Thank you.
All right. Yay. Okay. Now let's say hello to Lola Culver and Mary Backer. Hello, ladies. How are you? Lola's our current champion. She's won $1,200, and she's being challenged by Mary Backer. We're in the middle of round one. Is that right?
Right.
All right. You scored three celebrity matches in your end of the round, and your end of the round is about to come up.
And so, watch
fair enough. Yeah, that's fair enough. So, we'll see how this ends up right after this message. Now, middle of round one. Lola, ready?
Ready.
Goldberg, come here.
What the heck are you doing?
Where she didn't have the time cameras to go outside.
On. Trying to change her pants. They don't match.
I lost some Fanny's nice pop-up earrings.
Someone
tonight.
Told her her pants fell. Don't match with her jacket, so she's trying to change them in front of an entire audience. She doesn't care.
Hell, bananas up
as
there.
As long as Mr. Blackwell likes the way she's dressed.
Yes. It's all right if I go on with
we'll
the show.
Let them play.
Goldberg the Great does an amazing magic trick.
Uh-huh.
He can pass his blank through a bagel. Did you hear that, Lola?
I heard it.
Have you ever seen this act?
No.
It's a famous old act in vaudeville. Oh. Goldberg the Great. He passed his blank through a bagel. Finished?
No, we haven't even started.
You haven't even started?
I finished.
Write something there.
My mommy said I could.
Put your thing. Just write something.
I saw that. Oh, it's Hebrew. It
came out Hebrew, didn't it?
Oh, dear.
They'll be uprooting trees in Israel.
I'll help you.
All right, that's close enough. If spelling doesn't count, I got the idea. All right, Gary. Okay, here we go, Lola. Goldberg the Great does an amazing magic trick. He can pass his blank through a bagel.
I can't think of anything.
Neither could we.
Good. Fist.
His fist. What would you say, audience? Head. Pass his head through a bagel. What did you say, Michael?
That's what I said, his head.
Head, yeah, I think that's what I would have said, too. What'd you say?
I said he could pass his glasses through a bagel.
That would be difficult, wouldn't it? Yes.
You just take them off and you pass them through a bagel.
All right.
Boy, was that bad.
What does Gary Burghoff say?
Gary Burghoff says, I flunked spelling in the third grade, so I drew his assistant.
His assistant? Yes, I see her. Yeah, she
wearing
was a darling girl. Yeah, a marvelous likeness. What did you finally say? Show him now. I'll say it. You hold the card up and I'll say it.
Okay.
You misspelled it. There's an L in it.
There is?
Yeah, it's Yamulka.
Yamulka.
She got Yamaka. It looks like a Japanese bagel.
Oh, no.
No, it's Yamaka. A motorcycle.
Yamaka is a motorcycle.
Yamaka is a motorcycle. Oh,
through so a Jewish bagel, he passes a Japanese motorcycle.
Either way, it's a pretty dumb answer.
No, she said fist. What did you say? He can pass his fist through a bagel.
Well, I happen to know the lady he was married to.
She'd
been passing for years. So he passed his wife through
his wife through a bagel.
Magician.
Oh, a magician.
Levitation.
That would be terrific.
Well, thank you. We're happy
okay.
with it.
Okay.
Miss Stop, Start, Go.
I just wanted to say to my mother and a lot of people that don't know what a bagel is, it's a real hard donut. And he passed his body through. Don't turn on me.
I don't believe that.
Okay, that was round one, and that question was almost a total disaster.
I'll
Nobody
buy that.
$1,000, right?
Who
wrote that question?
I don't know, but whoever, take his name, whoever wrote that. You didn't write it, Pat? Joe, did you write that question? No. Blame it on Dick DiBartolo, who's in New York and is absent there. Did Bobby write that one? No. DiBartolo wrote it. All right. Here we go with round two. Would you please make a selection? Mary Baca.
Again.
A? Speak up, Mary.
B again.
Yeah. Okay.
I wish I were in
Brett B again. Brett and Gary do not play. Fanny does not play because you matched those three in the first round. Ted said, my racehorse is rocket-propelled. Before every race, I feed him blank. Ted said, my racehorse is rocket-propelled. Before every race, I feed him blank.
Are you playing?
No, I'm not playing. I decided against it.
I want to thank you for that lovely bouquet of crabgrass you sent to the hospital.
I want to thank you for these smart earrings I have on this evening.
Oh, yes. I love your choice of balls.
Okay.
Way off, Gary!
Don't go
already. Here we go, Mary Baca. Ted said, my racehorse is rocket-propelled. Before every race, I feed him.
Only thing I think of is gasoline.
What's that?
Gasoline.
Gasoline?
That's the only thing I could think of.
She said the only thing she could think of was gasoline. Michael, what did you say?
That's right. That's jet fuel. That's no, what that is.
No, jet fuel is really...
That's gasoline! Boom!
No, wait a minute. Jet fuel is kerosene.
Well, I'll write gasoline then.
No.
That's right.
No, you gotta be fair and fair. Now, jet fuel is kerosene, and she said gasoline.
Well, I didn't know that jet fuel wasn't gasoline.
Well,
thought
you
was...
just dumb, that's all. Yeah. I said. Well, you don't write to me. He made me say it. The devil made me do it.
That's the same.
All right, now, let's see. We skip those two and come down to you.
I don't like the way you say those two.
What are you worried about?
I don't like my answer at all.
Well, we haven't liked any
of
your
answers. Don't worry, nobody else will
Why
either, dear.
Why should this be an exception?
It's not very nice. I don't think I'll show it.
Well, you gotta show it.
Oh, okay.
What did she say? Terrific.
Well, I just saw that movie.
All right, let's pan over to Richard because the poor girl has suffered enough now. Go ahead, Richard.
Well, thank goodness I can bring a little class. Sauerkraut.
Oh, dear me. Now, so...
Nobody else.
Yeah, that's it. Okay. So you didn't score with that at all, fortunately. No, that's 3-0, and your question comes up in a moment or so, but right now we got to do a little business, so let's take a break and watch this. Now, here we go. Now, Lola, you must match 3 celebrities to stay in the game. 4 will win your third game. Ready? Who plays?
All of us.
All of us.
Oh, everybody plays. Yes, thank you.
All of you.
Marge said... I don't think my husband has no brains at all. He plays football without a blank. He says that.
I got it, darling.
I don't think
I
my
it.
Husband has no brains at all. He plays football without a blank.
I got it, honey. It's just smart. I just get this clever. I can't stand it.
You thinking about that, Lola? My heart said, I don't think my husband has no brains at all. He plays football without a blank. Ready down here, ready up there. Okay, so we come over here to Lola Cover. Don't think my husband has no brains at all. He plays football without a...
goalpost.
Say?
A goalpost.
She said goalpost.
Oh.
I think you just
no
blew
good,
it.
Huh? No
well,
good.
We'll find out right now. She says goalpost. Michael, what do you say?
Well, to be in good taste, I didn't say supporter, so then I said ball.
A ball.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, that's be difficult to do, play football without a football. What do you say?
You know how I feel about sports.
You don't like them. You don't
understand. I don't even want to see a ballet about football.
Okay.
I said a football, plays football without a football.
That's the answer. Okay, Gary.
No, you see, he was the person who made that statement. The woman was from Washington, D.C., and she said, without President Ford. No, that's not right. Without a helmet.
Without a helmet. You got to match the three remaining ones to stay in the game. Marge said, I don't think my husband has no brains at all. He plays football without a
ball.
Goalpost. Ball is the answer. What do we got there? Helmet. Okay, Mary Butler. Come on down. Congratulations. Now, Mary's got $100. You stand by for a moment or so while we say goodbye to Lola Culver. You're going to be leaving here with $1,200 and our best wishes.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
It was a pleasure meeting you, Lola. Goodbye. Lola Culver. Now, are you ready? Okay. Here it is. There's the big money supermatch board. You know how this goes?
Yeah.
We polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Blank Johnson. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250, then the third, $100. Which celebrities do you want some help from?
Richard.
I think President Johnson.
President Johnson? Okay.
Gary?
It's a very popular movie, I think, of last year, Jeremy Johnson.
Jeremiah
Johnson. That's
Jeremiah
right.
Johnson.
It wasn't that popular in my neighborhood.
Yeah, very popular. You never saw it, did you?
I saw a lot of the previews.
Oh, I see. All right.
And Brett.
How about Lady Bird?
Lady Bird. So you got Lady Bird Johnson, Jeremiah Johnson, and President Johnson. You want one of those or you want to give us one of your own?
Jeremiah Johnson.
She's made her decision. She wants Jeremiah Johnson.
Can I tell you what it is? Now that everybody's done it, it's Howard Johnson.
I know you might be right.
Bye.
What? Johnson and Johnson.
Johnson and Johnson. What do you think it is? It's what?
It's Esther Williams and Van Johnson.
It's Esther Williams and Van Johnson. All right, to each his own. Let's find out what it is. We are looking for Jeremiah Johnson. That was her choice. Let's find out if it's under the $100 response. Johnson and Johnson is up there. Okay, somebody just said that. Looking for Jeremiah Johnson, here's the $250 response. Van Johnson.
You
said that one. Okay. All the losers are coming up here. Okay, Jeremiah Johnson is what we want. Is it under the $500 response? Lyndon B. Johnson. That was his.
President.
Oh, who am I talking? I said LBJ.
No, he said President Johnson.
Sure.
It certainly wouldn't be
Why
Andrew,
did you doubt
would it?
Me, darling?
Yeah. Okay.
You go with Jeremiah Johnson? Yo-Yo thought it was Jerry Johnson.
So, Mary Baca, you have $100, and you're going to meet another player. So here comes Jerry Chiavetta. Hello there. Okay. Hi, Jerry. You know
Hi.
Mary?
You sure do.
Yeah. Now, tell us about Jerry Chiavetta.
Well, I have a lot of men in my life. I have my beautiful, fantastic husband, Michael, and I have a little boy for next week, that's Bobby, and a six-month-old baby, Andy.
Okay, and you're very happy about all that, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good luck to you here, Jerry. Shall we begin? There we go. Would you make a selection?
B.
Everybody plays? We have a new game.
Well, don't keep it to yourself.
I'll take that one home. Now, here it is. When Captain Hook goes to sleep, he hooks his hook to a blank.
I don't understand.
When Captain Hook goes to sleep, he hooks his hook to a blank.
Oh,
is that silly? Am I feeling silly or is that a silly? That's a silly question. So write something silly.
My answer is silly.
Got it?
My bad.
Okay. Come on, Fannie.
Gracious.
Don't be a female Charles Nelson Reilly and hold us all up that way.
That's a redundant statement.
All right. Here we go, Jerry. When Captain Hook goes to sleep, he hooks his hook to a blank.
The what?
Hooker.
Oh.
Which okay. version of Peter Pan did she read? I ask you.
She said, hooks is hooked to a hooker. What do you say?
I have hook.
Hook is what I said.
But there's the ER.
All right, Brett.
You know, a lot of people hitch their wagon to a star.
Yes.
But Captain Hook hooked his hook to a hooker.
Right. Well, that's one match. I thought Michael's answer was good. It was so nonsense.
Gotcha.
He hooks his hook to a hook, I thought was very fey. What do you say,
Five minutes
Gary?
Ago, they were mine. What happened? I'll soon they forget. I'm sure it's the seat. If Charles were here, was here, he would say,
it's Peter Pan. He hooked his hook to a fairy.
All right, what is she says he hooked his hook to a hooker. What do you say?
I didn't think that was very ladylike. To a porthole.
To a porthole.
Okay. That could be the same thing.
You know, you're going downhill.
I know, I'm sorry.
Doesn't
you
that match?
You started out so bright and gay, and now it's really...
I'm very sorry.
No. All right, Richard.
I think that's an excellent answer.
Do you hook his hook to a porthole?
Sure, that's the way he sleeps.
Yeah,
then two members of the crew run in, grab a leg each, and make a wish.
That's a porthole.
Oh!
Marty.
All right. Fanny Flagg.
Yes.
Is that you? Are you the real Fanny Flagg? Please stand up.
Yes. No, I was thinking he was a sleepwalker, and I said he hooked his hook to a bed.
To a bed. Wrong.
I still like you, though.
So it's one.
I think you need another week in the hospital, dear.
And before we come to the end of this round, we've got to do this message, so you stick around. Here we are. Middle of round one. Jerry Chiavetta scored once in hers. Now let's see how Mary Baca does in hers. Now, does everyone here remember Mission Impossible? Say yes.
Yes. How missioned was it?
How impossible.
All right. Now, one time the tape recorder said, good morning, Mr. Phelps. Your mission, should you decide to accept it, is to blank Brett Summers.
I'm gonna get lucky.
Your mission, should you decide to accept it, is to blank Brett Summers.
What would Paul in say?
All right, slide it in the slot. Lower tier is ready, upper tier.
Boy, is that bad.
Okay.
Oh, wait.
It's the worst of the week.
All right. Mary Baca. The tape recorder on Mission Impossible said, good morning, Mr. Phelps. Your mission, should you decide to accept it, is to blank Brett Summers.
Make love to.
Make love to Brett Summers, she says. All right, Michael, what'd you say?
Sober up.
Sober up. Talk about your missions impossible.
I'm only kidding. Right, sit up and eat your oatmeal and show us your answer there.
That's what I said.
What?
Sober up.
Sober up.
Shoot.
No, shoot. What did you say, Gare?
I said, find her and get the secret papers she keeps in her wig. But if she's wearing the red one, it's the wrong one. The yellow one, never. No, that's not it. I said, find. It's a
find.
Boring answer. So I
boring. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that.
Whoa.
These cables are tricky,
yes.
Aren't they? Okay, show us your answer, please.
To mugger.
To mugger?
Oh. Just because I made that honest remark about your dark roots, you've
You're
turned
gonna
on me.
You're just going to get it.
Okay.
That's what she keeps hoping for.
Here we go.
Comes under the heading of impossible dream. I said to stifle.
Stifle. And what do you say? She's looking for make love to.
Yes, well, it could be the same thing. I think any man would like to marry Brett.
to marry.
Yes.
Named
Phil.
No match there. So at the end of round one, it's 1-0, and now we've got to stop. And we've got this for you. All right, now listen, we thank all of you. You were just splendid. And you will come back, no matter what we said. You will come back. Some of the others, it's doubtful about them. Thank you, ladies. We'll see you next time. Now, the next time we get together, we are going to have this bunch of zanies.
Charlie Brill, Brett Summers, Richard Deacon, Joanne Flew, Richard Dawson, and Patty Dawson.
Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Goodbye. Middle of round one. Lola, ready?
Ready.
What are you doing
on Goldberg, come here.
What are you doing?
Where is she? Didn't have the cameras on.
Trying to change her pants. They don't match.
I lost some of Fannie's nice pop-up earrings.
Someone told her pants don't match with her jacket, so she's trying to change them in front of an entire audience. She doesn't care.
Hell, bananas up
there. As long as Mr. Blackwell likes the way she's dressed.
Let's ask you. It's all right if I go on with the show.
We'll let them play.
Goldberg the Great does an amazing magic trick.
Uh-huh.
He can pass his blank through a bagel. Did you hear that, Lola?
I heard it.
Have you ever seen this act?
No.
It's a famous old act in vaudeville. Oh. Goldberg the Great. He passed his blank through a bagel. Finished?
No, we haven't even started.
You haven't even started?
I finished.
Write something there.
My mommy said I could.
Put your thing. Just write something.
I saw that.
Oh,
well, it's Hebrew. It came out Hebrew,
didn't it?
Oh, dear.
They'll be uprooting trees in Israel.
I'll help you spell.
All right, that's close enough. Spelling doesn't count. I got the idea. All right, Gary. Okay, here we go, Lola. Goldberg the Great does an amazing magic trick. He can pass his blank through a bagel.
I can't think of anything.
Neither could we.
Good. Fist.
His fist. What would you say, audience? Head.
Get ready to match the stars. Mike 11. Brett Summers. Gary Burghoff. Joyce Bulifant, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there.
Hey, yes.
Johnny Olson, thank you, dear friends and gentle hearts. What?
You can't be a celebrity with your fans.
Thank you very much.
You look elegant.
Yeah, that's
I
really nice.
I wanted to wear that bow tie you bought for me in Paris, and it broke just as we were putting it on. The thread. What are you buying these cheap ties for?
You look terrific, but let me tell you.
What? He's gone bananas, hasn't he?
That's what my uncle was buried in one, just like.
Oh.
Can I come back?
Yeah, you can come back.
I'm just kidding.
Listen now. Are you still on All in the Family?
But starting Monday, we're going to be making a new show. They're going to be making a new show, and I'm just going to be in it, and it's about the Jefferson family, and it's going to be on right after All in the Family. Thank you.
All right. Yeah. Okay. Now let's say hello to Lola Culver and Mary Backer. Hello, ladies. How are you? Lola's our current champion. She's won $1,200, and she's being challenged by Mary Backer. We're in the middle of round one. Is that right? All right. You scored three celebrity matches in your end of the round, and your end of the round is about to come up. And so, watch
fair it. Enough.
Yeah, that's fair enough. So, we'll see how this ends up right after this message. Now,
that's the same.
All right, now let's see. We skip those two and come down to you.
I don't like the way you say those two.
What are you worried about?
I don't like my answer at all.
Well, we haven't liked any
don't
of
Don't worry,
your
nobody else will
Why
either, dear.
Why should this be an exception?
It's not very nice. I don't think I'll show it.
Well, you gotta show it.
Oh, okay.
Is it you? What did she say? Terrific.
Well, I just saw that movie.
All right, let's pan over to Richard because the poor girl has suffered enough now. Go ahead, Richard.
Well, thank goodness I can bring a little class. Sauerkraut.
Oh, dear me. Now, so...
Nobody else.
Yeah, that's it. Okay. So you didn't score with that at all, fortunately. No, that's 3-0, and your question comes up in a moment or so, but right now we got to do a little business, so let's take a break and watch this. Now, here we go. Now, Lola, you must match 3 celebrities to stay in the game. 4 will win your third game. Ready? Who plays?
All of us.
Oh, everybody plays. Yes. Thank you.
All of you.
Marge said, I don't think my husband has no brains at all. He plays football without a blank. He says that.
I got it, darling.
I don't think my husband has no brains at all. He plays his head through a bagel. What did you say, Michael?
That's what I said, his head.
Head, yeah, I think that's what I would have said, too. What'd you say?
I said he could pass his glasses through a bagel.
That would be difficult, wouldn't it? Yes.
You just take them off and you pass them through a bagel.
All right.
Or was that bad?
What does Gary Burghoff say?
Gary Burghoff says, I flunked spelling in the 3rd grade, so I drew his assistant.
His assistant? Yes, I see her. Yeah, she was a darling girl. Yeah, a marvelous likeness. What did you finally say? Show him now. I'll say it. You hold the card up and I'll say it.
Okay.
You misspelled it. There's an L in it. What
is there is?
Yeah, it's Yamulka.
Yamulka.
She got Yamaka. It looks like a Japanese bagel. There.
No, it's Yamaka. A motorcycle.
Yamaka is a motorcycle.
Oh,
through a Jewish bagel, he passes a Japanese motorcycle.
Either way, what? It's a pretty dumb answer.
No, she said fist. What did you say? He can pass his fist through a bagel.
Well, I happen to know the lady he was married to.
She'd
been passing for years. So he passed his wife through
his a bagel. His wife through a bagel.
Magician.
Oh, a magician.
Levitation.
That would be terrific.
Well, thank you. We're
okay.
With it.
Okay. Miss Stop, Start, Go.
I just wanted to say to my mother and a lot of people that don't know what a bagel is, it's a real hard donut. And he passed his body through. Don't turn on me.
I don't believe that. Okay, that was round one, and that question was almost a total disaster.
I'll buy that.
1,000, right?
Who wrote that question?
I don't know, but whoever, take his name, whoever wrote that. You didn't write it, Pat? Joe, did you write that question? No. Blame it on Dick DiBartolo, who's in New York and is absent there. Did Bobby write that one? No. DiBartolo wrote it. All right. Here we go with round two. Would you please make a selection? Mary Baca.
B again.
A? Speak up, Mary.
B again.
B again. Yeah. Okay.
I wish I were in B
Brett and Gary do not play. Fannie does not play because you matched those 3 in the first round. Ted said, my racehorse is rocket-propelled. Before every race, I feed him blank. Ted said, my racehorse is rocket-propelled. Before every race, I feed him blank.
Are you playing?
No, I'm not playing. I've decided against it.
I want to thank you for that lovely bouquet of crabgrass you sent to the hospital.
And I want to thank you for these smart earrings I have on this evening.
Oh, yes. I love your choice of balls.
Okay.
Wait up, Gary!
Don't go
All ready? Here we go, Mary Baca. Ted said, my racehorse is rocket-propelled. Before every race, I feed him.
Only thing I think of is gasoline.
What's that?
Gasoline.
Gasoline?
That's the only thing I could think of.
She said the only thing she could think of was gasoline. Michael, what did you say?
That's right. That's jet fuel. That's what that is.
No, jet fuel is really...
That's gasoline! Boom!
No, wait a minute. Jet fuel is kerosene.
Well, I'll write gasoline then.
No.
That's right.
No, you got to be fair and fair. Now, jet fuel is kerosene, and she said
gasoline.
Well,
I didn't know that jet fuel wasn't gasoline.
Well, then you're just dumb, that's all. Okay. That's all. Well, you don't write to me. He made me say it. The devil made me do it.